copyrighted program created for the Rio Grande Oil Company.
Los Angeles police calling all cars, attention all cars, broadcast 97, an escape from the county jail. Henry Stevens, age 19, height 5 feet 5 inches, 119 pounds. That's all. Rolls and circles.
Freak up in the October issue calling all cars news. Given away wherever Rio Grande cracked gasoline is sold. True detective stories, movie news, and pictures of new free gifts. Extra.
Friends, last night I had a thrilling demonstration of police car performance. The same police car performance I've been telling you about for years. In a police radio car powered by Rio Grande cracked gasoline, I rode about the streets for hours with two officers on duty. We didn't speed, we crawled. But as the driver said, that's a real test for gasoline, to burn so evenly you can throttle down to 5 miles an hour in high. Police have tried other gasolines, but their cars buck and jump and they have to shift gears. Only Rio Grande cracked gives smooth power at low speed. That's one reason why more police cars use Rio Grande cracked than any other gasoline. And the other reason? Well, when the police radio barks a demand for action, the throttle is clamped to the floor and Rio Grande cracked gives full speed instantly. Not a second lost in shifting gears. My exciting ride last night gave me actual proof of the superiority of Rio Grande cracked over other gasoline. And you will get the same convincing proof if you will use the same gasoline that police cars use in your car. And now it is our privilege to introduce Captain H.S. Seeger, commanding the robbery and narcotics squad of the Los Angeles Police Department. Captain Seeger.
Good evening, friends. No one within sound of my voice believes that he can be two places at once. And, quite naturally, he is better informed and acquainted with the place where he is at any given moment than any other place. Tonight, we are going to follow a man who, having committed a crime and been caught, still thought he could beat the game. We are going to follow him as he makes his escape and watch him as he believes he has made his getaway. He could not be two places at once. He could not know what the law was doing about him. We will show you that side of it, too. What the law did about this unfortunate, misled enemy of society. He could not be two places at once, but his pursuers, the police, representatives of the mass agreement of public opinion, which passes for decency and respect for the law, can be 2, 10, 100 places at once. Listen carefully, and you will hear the answer to this apparently paradoxical riddle.
But I'm telling you, the picture will be colossal, I tell you.
My dear, you could have seen the gorgeous gown I designed for Gloria Lamont. It was just too
wonderful. Papa. He never could forget.
I don't want to be in pickles.
Oh, it's been a simple, lovely party, Mr. Barber.
I'm so glad you enjoyed yourself, Mrs. Darrow.
Oh, it's so rarely we Easterners have an opportunity to mingle with you Hollywood celebrities. And to think that I've actually dined with some of the most famous actors on the screen. Well, my dear.
Well, we're just plain folks after all, Mrs. Darrow.
Yes, but interesting folks. Oh, I just hate to tear myself away.
I just wish you didn't have to leave just yet.
Oh, but I really must. such a long drive back to Pasadena. If I can just have my wrap.
Well, of course. Mary, this is our old thing.
Oh, oui, monsieur. Tout suite. And a French maid. Well, you certainly do things up in style, Mr. Harwell.
Oh, really?
Ah, yes. You movie directors have a way. You know how to dramatize your life. It's been a grand experience. Something to tell the girls at the club about.
Yeah. Et bien, moi, c'est au moins, I've been robbed. You made it perfectly. I've been emptied. All the next to the train, monsieur. See for yourself. It is very
wrong. Merciful help.
Come, Mrs. Darrow. Let's investigate.
Oh. Voilà, monsieur. Regardez. The place is a wreck.
Every purse empty. Furs ripped from coat.
Oh, Mr. Barber, look, my lovely ermine wrap. It's gone.
I'm so sorry, Mrs. Darrow. Marie, get the police on the wire at once.
Oh, really, Mr. Uh-huh.
Here's where he enters, through the window here. Use the 3/4-inch jimmy to open the screen. Now I'll just see if I can find any fingerprints.
Oh, Mr. Barber, are you a detective?
No, but I've been staying up on these things. I'm going to do a gangster picture next.
It has been marvelous, these few brief moments. Paradise on earth.
Yeah?
Oh, I'm so happy that you stayed after the others. I've seen so little of you these past few weeks.
Well, I've been busy, Cynthia.
Busy? Oh, wow. It is so strange. A million men from all over the world. My great picture public would never be too busy to come to Cynthia Laflamme's apartment. And you... Paul Whittlesey, the great lover of the screen, the only one for whom Cynthia Laflamme feels the surge of her engulfing passion, remains cold and distant. Oh,
come on, Cynthia. Say that stuff for the chatter writers. You are still Sally Swart, a darn good tap dancer to me. And I ought to still be Johnny Benson, the best ventriloquist on Orpheum time to you. Sounds like you're beginning to believe the stuff they write about you.
Oh, Raoul. You are so material. Come, sit back while I play you some Debussy.
Debussy? When I first knew you, your idea of classical music was Carrie Jacobs Bond.
Yes, but I have come to know and love the finer things.
Yeah, well, that's just great. You love them by yourself. I got to be getting home.
Oh, no. Don't leave
me. Now, listen, Sally, somebody's got to be sensible. Your husband will be home any minute. Maybe you've forgotten that he was the best agent I ever had, but I ain't forgotten what Ben Goldberg did for me in the old days, and I ain't chiseling on his marble.
Oh, well, I despair of you.
Yeah, well, that's just too bad. Where's my coat?
In the bedroom. Oh, my heart is crushed. The room is crushed. The lover I had is gone.
Hey, Cynthia, the joint's been robbed.
What?
Yeah, come here. Look, my camel hair coat's gone. And your dressing table's a wreck. The screen's been broken in.
Well, what else can happen to disrupt my peaceful sorrow? My heart broken, my home violated. It does not matter. I can get more perfume. Money? I have more than I need of that.
Hey, Johnny.
What?
Look, the low-down rat.
Well, what's the matter?
He stole my rabbit's foot, the one I carried since I broke into just some time from that amateur night on 10th Avenue.
Eddie.
Yes, Captain?
A Hollywood party burglar pulled another job last night.
Yeah? What'd he get this time?
As usual, furs, perfumes, and what dough he found in the bedroom. The boys out at the Hollywood station haven't anything on him. He never leaves fingerprints. I want you and your partner to handle this.
Okay.
I suggest you go down the hall to the records bureau and get Rhoda Cross to run the suspect cards through the Hollerith machine. Find out how he operates.
All right. But I never could understand that dingus they got down there.
Well, it's about time you found out about it. Ask Rhoda to explain it. She's a good egg.
What's on your mind?
Oh, this mug out in Hollywood who's breaking into people's boudoirs.
Well, what do you want on him?
Well, the cap suggested you run your suspect cards through the machine and see what you've got. Only I don't know what that's going to prove.
No? Well, I'll show you. Come on over here. Now, let's see. We'll take this stack of cards here.
These are burglaries for the past 2 months. Each card represents the information on a job, see?
Yeah, but these cards just have numbers on them with holes punched every so often.
I know, but they all mean something. Mm-hmm. Now tell me, what's this robber's modus operandi?
What? Huh? Oh, you mean how does he work?
Yeah.
Well, now, according to our report from Hollywood, he knocks over houses where parties are being held. Enters bedrooms on the first floor with a 3/4-inch jimmy. Steals furs, expensive clothes, and money belonging to the guests.
Okay. Let's segregate these cards for burglaries in Hollywood. We'll set the machine here and let it sort the cards.
Hey, some of those cards are falling in one slot and the rest are falling in another.
That's right. Now, this stack represents the robberies in Hollywood. See, they're all punched on number 3 in the second column of figures. Now, we'll set the machine for entry by 3/4-inch jimmy. That's 6 in the fourth column. Entry in first floor bedroom, that's 2 in the first column. And theft of clothes and furs, that's 3 in column 10. And theft of money, now, that's 4 in the sixth column. Here we go. All right, Eddie. All these jobs were done by a 3/4-inch jimmy. We'll shoot them through now for the first floor bedroom. We got 8 first floor bedrooms. Now for the clothes and furs. Six of them take clothes and furs, and I'll bet they also took money. Let's see. Yep, take money, too. Here's your man, Eddie. 6 jobs in 2 months. Always enters first floor bedrooms with 3/4-inch jimmy. Steals clothes, furs, and money. And, say, wait a minute. According to these cards, homes burglarized are in every case prominent picture people. And that gives me an idea.
No, it's all beyond me.
Say, you dicks couldn't operate without this record bureau of ours. Now, just a minute, Eddie. I was reading something in the paper this morning. Wait a minute. Here it is. Jaime Goldfish, the Eternal Pictures producer, will entertain a select group of 200 guests this evening at a buffet supper in honor of Count Etienne Poissondor. That's your lead, Eddie.
What do you mean?
Listen, Mr. Goldfish's house is a low single-story affair. Get it? Easy to get at that room where the guest wraps will be. Now, you get out there tonight and hide in the bedroom with the coats and hats, and you'll arrest your mysterious burglar, or I'll buy you a platinum-plated badge.
I don't get you, Rhoda.
It's simple. I'm reasoning on Chief Ballmer's theory. When he set up this record bureau, he said that if you had a sufficient record of frequency of crime and modus operandi, you could bring crime to an absolute end by having officers on hand to welcome the criminal when he arrived to commit his crime.
It's all Greek to me.
Well, here's a chance to see if it works. My guess is that your party burglar will fall into your arms tonight.
Well, it looks to me, Rhoda, as though you ought to be a detective.
I am a detective, but nobody knows it.
Hey, I think there's a runaround, Eddie.
Well, that's all we got to work on.
Yeah, but how can a dame who runs a filing dingus at headquarters know anything about policing?
Well, it's worth a try.
Yeah. Here we are stuffed in Mrs. Goldfish's clothes closet. And all them pretty Janes out there to drinking champagne. She and any self-respecting dick works a party like this by mingling with the guests.
Okay, you can do your mingling after we catch this one.
Yeah, if we catch him.
Oh! What's the matter?
One of Mrs. Goldfish's guard has just put my eye out, that's all.
Shh.
What's up?
What happened? Open the door.
Hey, pick up the guy through that window.
Well, obvious, come on.
Pick him up. Hey, what the devil?
You're under arrest. What did I tell you, Ray?
Oh, I knew we'd catch him all the time.
You knew. Rhoda Cross knew you knew.
So early in January of 1933, Henry Stevens is arrested by Los Angeles police and sent to the county jail to await trial. But Stevens, although young, is a tough hombre, and his philosophy contains the salient credo that iron bars do not a prison make. On the night of January 28, 1933, Stevens escaped by shimmying down the side of the building with the assistance of the rope and the flagpole. While Los Angeles County officers and city police search for him, let us follow the trail of this wily criminal ourselves.
Bill, what can I do for you?
How much for that sailor's pea jacket in the window?
Bill, I'll tell you. It's a good
thing. All right, never mind the sales talk. How much do you want for it?
$2 and a half.
I'll give you $2 for it if you throw in the pan.
What? $2? And depends for him besides? Say, what do you think I'm saying?
Hey, what are you talking about? That coat ain't worth a dime.
Why, I paid the $2 for it myself.
Yeah, I know. Now, look, I only got $2. You want it or don't you?
Well, all right, if that's the way you feel
about
it.
Yeah, that's the way I feel about it. Here.
Oui, I'm just giving it away. Oui, that's what I'm doing, giving it away. Hey, wait a minute. What's that printing on your pen?
None of your business. They're my laundry mark.
Laundry mark, huh? Looks like it numbered from a jailhouse. I think I better call the police.
I can't understand it, Captain. We searched every corner of the jail.
He's got to be in here. There's no way he could get out.
Yeah, between 10 o'clock at night and 6 in the morning, there's not many people around this building.
There's two guards. It's the only unlocked entrance all night long, isn't there?
Yeah, but it's noon now, and I'm...
Wait a minute. Hello? Yeah? Yeah?
What?
No, bring him up here. I want to talk to him. Yeah, and listen, Murphy. Notify every patrol car and send out complete description to every desk sergeant in the city. You're right, Eddie. He did get out. He just bought a coat and a pair of pants in a misfit clothes parlor on Main Street.
State Bureau of Criminal Identification and Investigation. Wanted for escape, Los Angeles County Jail, January 27th, 1933. Henry Stevens, alias Joseph Benelli, alias John Vincent, height 5 feet 5 inches, weight 119 pounds, dark brown hair and eyes, fingerprint classification 13 or 14 ulnar over ulnar outer, outer 14, Los Angeles County number 173788, record San Diego County number 37726, Salt Lake County number 6010. Arrest, hold, and notify. That's all.
When do we get into Reno, pal?
I don't know. About daybreak, I think.
What was that last time we passed?
Lucky. Never been there?
No, not that I remember.
I spent 2 months in the can there last summer. Boy, what a dump. You'd think the town would be ashamed to own such a jail.
My back feels like it's broken.
Yeah, mine too. Hey, you know, riding the rods ain't much of a luxury on this line. Now, you take the Boston and Maine, for instance. They got all the comforts of home. There's a crossbar that runs right from the axle here over to this basin, and you can throw your leg over that, and you'll feel like you're sitting in the lobby at the Ritz.
Well, I wonder what we're stopping for now.
I don't know. They're always monkeying around about something.
Hey, here comes a brakeman with a lantern.
Oh, nuts.
Make a dive for them bushes. That's a break for you, ain't it? Well, there she goes.
Man, it's all right with me. I was thinking of getting off anyhow. I never did like this line. The service is rotten.
Los Angeles County number 173788. Record San Diego County number 37726. Salt Lake County number 6010. Arrest, hold, and notify. Where'd you say to send this one, Chief?
Reno, Nevada.
Huh?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm trying to work my way back to my folks in Iowa.
Been out to Hollywood?
No, been up to San Francisco.
Pretty hard to get work these days, ain't it?
Yeah. It's a nice car you got.
Yeah, ain't it? Just bought a brand new months ago. It's got all kinds of fancy gadgets on it. You're going all the way into Reno?
Yeah.
Well, I can take you right in, because I'm
all right,
going.
Stick him up. Huh? You heard me. Stop this car and stick up your hands. I got a gun in this left pocket, so don't try anything funny.
Well, for heaven's sake, sir.
All right, shut up the motor.
Hey, listen here, now,
Shut up or I'll plug you. Have you got any money? Oh, you don't want a fork, huh?
There's $30 in the wallet.
All right, hand it over. Here, you can keep your driver's license.
Thank
now
you.
Get out.
My wife's waiting for me in town.
Oh, no, shut up.
Salt Lake County number 6010. Arrest, hold, and notify.
Anything new on Stevens, Chief?
Yeah, we got a wire from Reno.
Fellow that swiped a car and robbed an old man of $30 sounds a lot like Stevens from the description.
Where does this one go?
Care of John A. Hampton, City Hall, St. Louis, Missouri.
The road to St. Louis.
St. Louis? Oh, you're off the St. Louis road, but you want to turn your left back at the crossing.
Ah, nuts. If you don't mind giving me a lift, I can show you a shortcut.
All right. Hop in. Where you going?
Blake Town. It's not far, about 20 miles. You want to turn to your left when you get down here, Wade.
Okay.
This is quite a lift. Save me bus fare. Of course, you step on it, don't you?
Yeah, don't let any grass grow into my feet.
Gee, what are we doing, 60?
What do you care? You'll get this waist out quicker.
Oh, it's all right with me, only there's generally a lot of speed cops on this road.
Yeah?
Well, gosh, there's one now.
Where?
Right back of us. You might as well slow up. Here he comes.
No, thanks, buddy. No, thanks.
Hey, what are you doing? You're only making trouble on yourself.
That's my business.
Hey, are you crazy? You're doing
fine.
Look out, there's a turn. Oh, yes.
I'm sorry, Mac. I can't hang around here.
Are you hurt?
Yeah, my left arm.
Are you driving this car?
No.
Where's the driver?
He just ran through those bridges.
Sheriff George A. Downey, Cook County, Chicago, Illinois. Wanted for escape, County Jail, Los Angeles, January 27th. Frank Stevens, age 19, height 5 feet.
Sheriff Charles W. Watkins, Boston, Massachusetts. Wanted for escape, County Jail, Los Angeles.
Sheriff Raymond L. Connors, Atlanta, Georgia. Wanted for escape, County Jail, Los Angeles, January 27th.
Sheriff Thomas L. DeLand, Memphis, Tennessee. Wanted for escape, County Jail, Los Angeles, January 27th.
Mighty wet night to be outside.
Go on, beat it. I'm broke.
Sure enough?
Yes, sure enough.
So am I.
Well, what do you want to hang around me for?
I don't know. Reckon I'm tired talking to myself.
You do that, too?
Uh-huh. Life is just a bowl of cherries, ain't it?
You said it.
You all live around Memphis?
No.
Just hitting the road, huh?
Yeah.
Got any foes?
None that I'd brag about.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Say, look here. I know a Greek that runs that little restaurant on the other side of the bridge. Maybe I can put the bee on him for a couple of cups of coffee. What do you say?
Well, it's okay with me.
Hey, you! Hey!
Here comes that copper again.
Yeah, I thought I told you to stay over my beat.
Oh, George, I wasn't making no bother. I was just going to take the kid over to the grease and get him a cup of coffee.
Yeah, sure, I know. Now, you go on and beat it, or I'll lock you up.
Oh, all right. So long, kid.
So long.
What does a young fella like you want to be hanging around dames like that for? Now, go on now and get out of here. Going home to your mother.
Yeah, okay, officer. Yeah, I'll go home to my mother.
Fingerprint classification 13 over 14, owner over owner. Outer, outer 14. Arrest, hold, and notify. Where does this one go, Cap?
Pensacola, Florida.
Your money's worth or your money back. the same oil used by the United States Army and Navy, Sinclair oil, and it's sold the world over. When you drive in for Rio Grande cracked gasoline, get Sinclair motor oil, too. Then you'll really get police car performance in your own car.
The police calling all cars, attention all cars, cancellation broadcast 97 regarding an escape from the county jail. The man is now in custody. That's all. Roll and close.
Frederick Lindsley, bidding you good night.